So, you've been forced to use a high ISO, whether it be from the conditions that you're shooting in, or settings, or some other unfortunate circumstance, you still have noise within your photo, right? But all is not lost. To finish up the series on using a higher ISO in your photography, and then combating against that noise, I want to spend a little bit of time with you working on the processing of our images in order to reduce that noise. So like everything else in photography, your mileage might vary, but these techniques are techniques that I use to help mitigate noise within my own photos. And I hope that you pick up a tidbit of information or a tool that can help you out so you can fold it into your own workflow. But also bear in mind that this is not a one or the other type conversation either. You can employ these post-processing techniques in conjunction with other tips from this series. So there will be a link to the playlist of all of these videos at the end of this video that you can follow in case you missed any of those others. So the great thing about working on the noise in post-processing are the wealth of tools that are available to you in order to help reduce the noise within your photos. Today, I'm going to cover tools that are available in Adobe Photoshop, since Photoshop is the primary tool that I use to process my images. But not to worry, if you are a Lightroom user, some of these tools are also natively available to you as well. But also, a lot of these techniques can be performed in most image editing platforms like Capture One or Topaz AI or even the open source GIMP project and more. They might just be under a different name. So let's get started, shall we? Now, in order to help understand how to employ these tools, it is probably best to understand what type of noise that you're dealing with in the first place, right? There are two main types of noise that I'm going to cover here, and that's going to be the luminance noise and the color noise. Both have their own unique properties that can be dealt with in much different ways. The first up is going to be color noise, also known as chromatic noise. This noise actually appears when color is distorted within your image. So have you ever noticed those unflattering specks of color on your images? That's color noise, and it appears as a variety of colors instead of the color showing as solid. Color noise is more visible in the underexposed portions of your images or within your shadows. This is why, when employing noise reduction techniques in the field, we would use the expose to the right method, because we would then expose for the shadows more, only to bring that exposure down, reducing the visibility of the noise within those areas. So the second type is going to be luminance noise. Luminance noise will show up as grain within your images, much like you would see that crystal grain that would show up in film photography. With luminance noise, you will not see any color variations within your image like you would with color noise. This type of noise refers to the brightness of your image instead of the colors and will generally present as darker or lighter specks within your image. So now the first step to dealing with noise is obviously to identify the image or images that you want to reduce noise in. If you don't have any of those, congratulations, this video is over for you now. But if you're still watching, when you select your image, one of the things that you want to do is evaluate the noise level within the image. And to do that, you're going to need to zoom into the image or blow it up a little bit. Not a lot, but just enough to the point where the noise is much more noticeable within the image. If you zoom in too far and then try to correct for that noise at a much higher level, you may see yourself running into some frustration because there's going to be a level of noise or pixelation or even errors within your file that just cannot be eliminated in those cases. So no pixel peeping. Then for the zoom, I would actually recommend zooming in over 100% and upwards of 150 to 175% zoom, but not much farther than that, because then you get into the pixel peeping range. So using these images, let's start with the Camera Raw plugin and see what options are available to us. The first option that is available is the single button click of the AI noise reduction feature that is available under the details section within the Camera Raw plugin. I really do like this feature a lot because it does speed up the workflow a little bit, and it does a pretty okay job of reducing the noise without creating a lot of blurring of the image. The downside to this is it creates a secondary file that you now have to work with and store. The next tool is available within the same section and is going to be the manual noise reduction settings below the AI noise reduction button. So those sliders are going to be pretty straightforward to help guide you towards cleaning up the noise within your image. Once you start moving the luminance slider, you will have the opportunity to also adjust the detail and contrast sliders nested underneath it as well. Then when you are able to do the same with the color noise slider, underneath the color noise slider will be nested the detail and smoothness adjustments. Using these adjustments will have a similar effect to the AI version, because because it is manipulating a lot of the same settings, but this time you are in control and not your computer. So the last tool that I'm going to talk about is going to be within Photoshop itself, and it's going to be within the filters, aptly named Reduce Noise, found under the menu heading Filters and then Noise. In that filter, you're going to be presented with four sliders that you can adjust for the noise, much like you did with the Camera Raw plugin manual settings. There is also an advanced version within that window where you can make adjustments to the noise based on an RGB channel breakdown of the image. So if you just want to reduce noise in one channel, you can do that. Now also, when using this filter, I would suggest duplicating the background layer and make the changes on the new layer so that way you can revert back to the original or apply a mask to the areas of the image that you do not want to apply this filter to. And also, so you're not applying settings over top each time, I would also suggest turning that layer into a smart object so that way you can adjust, save the settings, and then go back for more adjustments if you feel that it is necessary. And as you can see, I'm not going crazy with making adjustments in all these cases. And depending on the image, you may or may not employ all of these techniques, or even to such a degree that I have here. There is one thing that I do want to warn you about, is when you have done some noise reduction and you want to introduce some sharpening in your image to refine the edges, do so carefully. If you start to apply too much sharpening to an image, you end up with halos or other types of artifacts in your image that you probably do not want there and could actually look a little bit worse than the noise that you eliminated. So make sure you find a few images that have some noise in them, play around with these tools, see how they perform. By doing that, you may find a method that works best for you in your photography and then fits within your workflow. And as always, make sure to get out there, take some great photos. Thank you very much for coming along. Make sure to check out this playlist here that has all of the images within the series, and I'll see you again next time. Take care.